student, myself Rajendra Asiri. I am assistant professor in computer science department at government Bangad PG College, Didwana. In the previous lecture, we have discussed various aspects of authentication services like Kerberos, X.509 services, clear? And now in today's lecture, we will be focusing on the security at the transport layer. So at transport layer, security is being provided by SSL and TLS. SSL stand for Secure Socket Layer and TLS stand for Transport Layer Security, right? So in this upcoming lecture series, we will be focusing on various concepts like web security consideration. Means while deploying the web security, what are the various possible consideration aspect we need to focus on? We will be discussing in this lecture. Next, we will be focusing on SSL Secure Socket Layer and Transport Layer Security, that is TLS. And in the next lecture, we will be focusing on SET, Secure Electronic Transaction. Now, whenever we are doing any web security applications or when we are applying web security, then there are various consideration we need to apply. First, the web is very, very visible, right? Means web is basically a network of networks. It is widely, widely extended. So it is visible to all. So security is must to deploy. Right, means whenever we used to say that when a content or any file is on the net, then it is unsecure or it is we can say accessible to all, right? So it is the web is very, very much visible to all, so we need to consider web security. Second point, complex software hide many security flaws, clear? So in every security application, there are various we can say fault are there, various flaws are there, clear? Bugs are there. So a complex software can hide those flaws, clear? And based on those flaws, security might be compromised. So here we need to deploy web security concept, right? Third, web server are easy to configure and manage. This is also very important consideration while deploying the web security. Next, users are not aware of the risk. Suppose I am the user and using the content on the internet or web, then I am very much unaware. Clear? I am not aware of the risk which can be associated with any of the process which I am using. So these all are the consideration we need to focus on while applying the web security, clear? Now, security facilities in the TCP and IP protocol. We all know that whenever a communication is held on in a network from a source to destination, then the communication is divided in a step-by-step layered architecture. The architecture, well-known architecture, is TCP/IP protocol stack. In that, the top layer is application layer. After that, there is a session layer, clear? Presentation session layer is there. After that, transport layer is there. After that, network layer is there, data link layer is there, and then at the bottom, physical layer is there, which is responsible for the physical communication in the bit by bit format, right? At the data link layer, the bit is combined and form the frame. At the network layer, packets will be there. At the transport layer, segments will be there. When the segments are combined, then it will make a message, clear, which is transmitted by the application layer. So at every layer, there are different protocols which will ensure the security of the TCP/IP protocol stack. Right. So if I consider at the network layer, then at the network layer, the protocols are used for application layer protocol, transport layer protocol, and network layer protocol, like HTTP, Hyper Text Transfer Protocol. It is used for the various type of application layer protocols, like whenever we are transferring a file, whenever we are making a communication between client to server, client is requesting something from the server, then server is responding in the form of the required content, then the protocol used is HTTP. And when we apply HTTPS, then it is Hypertext Transfer Protocol in a secure manner, right? Next application protocol is FTP, that is File Transfer Protocol, right? It is used, as the name implies, it is a file transfer protocol. So whenever we are transferring a file from client to server or from one source to another another receiver, then for the file transfer file transmission, FTP protocol is very, very important. SMTP, Simple Mail Transfer Protocol, generally used for the mailing applications, and all these HTTP, FTP and SMTP worked on application layer, right? Next is TCP, that is Transfer Control Protocol. It is deployed at transport layer and it is responsible for all the transport layer security, okay? Next is Network Layer Protocol, that is IP or IPsec, Internet Protocol Security. Okay, next combination is transport level security. Whenever we are talking about transport layer security, transport layer comes between application layer and the network layer, clear? So in the previous case, that was network layer level. In the network level, transport layer consideration we are not applying, but at the transport layer level we are applying transport layer protocol also. So at the top, if you see, I'm taking the marker. At the top, it is the application layer protocol, that is HTTP, Hypertext Transfer Protocol. Second is FTP, File Transfer Protocol. Third, SMTP, Simple Mail Transfer Protocol. After that, next is the transport layer security. For transport layer security, we are using SSL or TLS, Secure Socket Layer or Transport Layer Security. After that, TCP protocol is there, that is transfer control protocol, and after that IP protocol, responsible for network layer, clear? Now next very important point, application level security. At application level, there are various protocol like SMI, Secure Multi-Purpose Internet Mail Extension Protocol. It is used for the email security. Next is PGP, that is Pretty Good Privacy Protocol. It is also used for network communication as well as email security. Next is SET, Secure Electronic Transaction. It is used for the, as the name implies, whenever we are making a transaction, then to make that transaction in a secure manner, SET plays very important role. Clear? SET will ensure the secure electronic transaction. After that, Kerberos, we already discussed in the previous lecture. Kerberos is basically a centralized authentication service in which there are various services, ticket granting service there, then ticket granting, we can say timestamp is there, validity is there, various type of cryptographic algorithm, digital signature is being applied in the process. So it will ensure the security in the centralized manner, right? From client to server as well as server to client in a two-way manner. Next is SMTP, that is Simple Mail Transfer Protocol, used for mailing applications. HTTP for the web application, Hypertext Transfer Protocol. So these all are the protocol used at the application layer. After that, transport layer. At the transport layer, there are two type of protocol. User datagram protocol, that is connectionless protocol. No three-way handshaking is applied here because we are not making any connection. It is a connectionless protocol, right? So it is easy to we can say it is less time consuming because three-way handshaking is not applied here. And second is TCP, Transfer Control Protocol. It used three-way handshaking. It means here it is more time consuming, clear? So first sender is sending request to the receiver is sending the acknowledgement, and then again sender is sending the acknowledgement to the receiver, clear? So in this manner, TCP handshaking process will be established. And after that, IP, Internet Protocol, used for network layer. So in this manner, security facilities is being provided in the TCP/IP protocol stack. Now, SSL and TLS. What is basic difference? क्लियर? सो SSL वाज और ओरिजिनेटेड बाय द नेटस्केप कंपनी. TLS वर्किंग ग्रुप वाज फॉर्म्ड विद इन IETF इंटरनेट इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स एंड टास्क फोर्स. क्लियर? एंड फर्स्ट वर्जन ऑफ TLS कैन बी व्यूड एज एन SSL वर्जन 3.1. Now in SSL architecture there are various type of component which are responsible for different purposes. So we are starting and we are doing one by one. First is SSL handshake protocol. As the name implies, for making the handshaking process, this SSL handshake protocol plays an important role. So it is responsible for that. Second is SSL change cipher specification protocol. All the cryptographic type of processes, cryptographic applications, SSL change cipher specification protocol plays important part. Next is SSL alert protocol. Fourth is HTTP, used for web application type of things. Next is SSL record protocol. For all the we can say session recording or for maintaining a particular session, timestamp related things, SSL record protocol plays important role. Next is TCP. And last is IP. Clear? So in this lecture we have discussed, starting from web security consideration, why web security is very important in today's environment. So all these concepts we will discuss. After that, how to provide security facilities at different layers. So different scenario we have discussed, like network level security, after that transport level security. Here in transport level security, SSL and TLS plays important role. For network level, IP security is very important. And in the application level, various protocol as MIME protocol, PGP protocol, SAT protocol, Kerberos protocol, SMTP protocol and HTTP protocol. After that, in SSL and TLS, both are doing the same things, SSL and TLS, but TLS generally we used to deploy nowadays, right? And the latest version of TLS can be viewed as SSL version 3.1. This is the latest version. And SSL architecture, in SSL architecture, various type of fields are there, and every field is responsible for different purpose. Like one protocol is responsible for handshaking purpose, three-way handshaking purpose. Second is responsible for all the cryptographic processes, all the cryptographic step. So cipher related task like SSL change cipher specification protocol, right? SSL alert protocol is also there for making all the alerts for different flags. Clear? And HTTP for the web application deployment. Then SSL record protocol is there, and TCP is responsible for the we can say transfer control protocol. For all the transport layer security, TCP is very important. And IP is here for the IP security, and that is security at the network layer. Clear? So in this manner, security can be ensured at the transport layer. We will focus more light on the SSL in the upcoming lecture. So in today's lecture, that's all. Thank you all.